Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you what is typecasting in Java. Casting one type of information to another type is known as typecasting. The typecasting can be done in two types, that is primitive data type casting and the second one is class typecasting. In primitive data type casting, the data type is cast to another data type. And in primitive data type casting, we have two types of casting, that is widening and narrowing. Widening can be done when casting lower data type to any of the higher data type, and narrowing can be done when casting higher data type to any of the lower data type. And what I'm going to tell you, keep this in mind. The widening operation can be done implicitly by the compiler. This widening can be done by the compiler also. So it is called as implicit widening or auto widening. And this narrowing cannot be done implicitly. The narrowing should be done explicitly, and compiler cannot perform narrowing, because whenever narrowing is performed, data loss happens. Let me take one example to illustrate primitive data type casting. The class name I have declared as primitive. Program started, program ended. Int x1 equal to .35. As you know, this 39.95 is not an integer value, but it is being casted to int type and then it is initialized to x1. Next is double y1 equal to double. And this 10 doesn't have decimal points, decimal values, and hence it is not a double value, but it is being typecasted. Let us print value of x1. And y1 value also. Next is int a equal to 20 double b equal to 29.95. Int x2 equal to int b. This is variable typecasting. Double y2 equal to double e. Y2. Save the program. Dot out dot println. four errors. We'll see what is the error first. Print dot out dot. No suitable method found for print ln. Value of x1 is 39, but the value of x1 what we have initialized is 39.95. this double value is converted to int, and the int value is assigned to x1 and it is printed as 39. Then in the same case, the y1 value, if you see y1 value what I am given in the code is 10, and it is being converted to a double, so the you can see the decimal value 10.029. you can see here that is the 29.95. the decimal value is cut and it is converted to integer and it is printed as 29. Okay, the same way y2, that is 20, which is the value of a, it is being converted to double and the double value is printed for the value y2 20.0. let me give some examples here. Int x1 equal to int 34.56. this is explicit narrowing. Int x2 equal to int b, explicit narrowing. Double b equal to 39.95. see the process what we are doing here. This is explicit narrowing. When you do explicit narrowing, as I said, we may lose the data. The data we are losing is 0.95. this value will not be printed for x2. The value which will be printed for x2 will be only 39. So there is a data lost. That is why implicit narrowing cannot be done or should not be done. It is better to do explicit narrowing. Okay, and next is double y1 equal to 28. Implicit widening. Are we doing any type conversion here? No, but compiler will do for ourselves, and it is called as auto widening. Here if I give int a equal to 15 and y2 equal to a, this is also implicit widening, because the value of a is 15, and when implicit widening is done, the value of y2 will be 15.0. so it is clear now, I think. If you have any doubts, you can put your doubts on the comments. I'll get back to you. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel.